was gonna stay and eat inside McDonald's, but you put shit in certain places around certain people and people just don't know how to act. They arguing over who was in line and all this other type of shit. And then it's crowded as hell. So I guess because it's lunchtime. So I really don't want to be bothered. So I think I'm gonna walk home and take my food home. Damn. Yeah, I'm just gonna walk home instead of staying in there. So it's fucking cold anyway. And you know how you are after you finish eating. Your ass just wanna like open up your pants and sit back, right? So I'm gonna wait until I get in the house. Yo, it's like fucking really cold. I can't believe how cold it is. I mean, I wouldn't go as far as say I love New York, but I like New York. One of the things that makes me not like New York is the weather. This shit is so goddamn bipolar. Mother Nature don't know what she wanna do. So I can't wait till the summertime or the spring at least. I think spring starts when, the 20th or the 21st? I think one of them. So I'll just be able to get out more, which would be really good. Sometimes I wish that I was in a relationship. You know, you miss that companionship and shit. And being single for all these damn years. I think I've been single since Junior was either 2 or 3 or some shit like that. And Junior's 9, okay? And when I mean single, I mean single. In every sense of the word, single. But I come across men and they I don't know what it is today that some men, I'm not gonna say all because it's stupid to generalize people, but the batch that I come across, they just don't know how to speak with you when they approach you. They come with some 20-year-old shit, like shit that you would say to like a 20-year-old, and they think that shit is cute, you know. When you first meeting somebody or trying to approach somebody, you don't just automatically start talking about they damn body parts. Like, what you think, I don't get dressed in the morning, I don't see my ass is fat and my titties are big? I don't need you to point that out to me of how good you think it looks. It's just, I don't know, I think that when you get older, I'm 40, so things that I thought was cute when I was in my 20s, and this shit ain't cute no more. And you got like 50-year-olds, 40-year-olds still with that same 20-year-old mentality trying to approach women that it's like in their 40s. You know what I'm saying? Like, get out of here with that bullshit. You walking up to me with your pants sagging down and you looking like a fucking roughneck and shit. That shit does not impress me. That's hard. That just doesn't, you know, just say good morning. You know, my name is such and such. You know, you look very lovely. Some shit like, I ain't even a guy and I got game, okay? I got better lies than these guys come up with today. So I don't know, maybe when I move to Texas, maybe I'll find somebody. That's in another 3 years, I don't know. Because these, like I said, I don't want to generalize everybody, but these New York cats ain't got no game. They with the bullshit, you know what I'm saying? Like, I don't know, it's not a turn on anymore. So yeah, it's not a turn on. It's just not appropriate. Like, and this is the thing with most young ladies or women don't realize is that the way they approach you, I'm not gonna say all the time 100%, but the way that a man approaches you, it says a lot about him. If you're approaching me and your pants are sagging down, not to say that the looks are what means everything, but you always judge people on your first impression. You know, the way they look, the way they speak, the way they carry themselves. And if you're approaching me, you're like in my age bracket with the sagging pants and the, you know, 20-year-old dress code. And then you approach me with some lame ass fucking pickup shit. Like, come on, dude. Like, that just tells me a lot about you. Just in that short period of time of whether I'm interested or not. No. I'm not saying like I'm always well put together, you know, all the time. But if I'm going outside, which I hate what I see what people do. People wear their pajamas outside. That shit is the most ratchetest ass shit. Okay? So, I'm not coming outside in my pajamas, you know, look like I done rolled the fuck out of the bed. I've seen people actually go food shopping in their pajamas. I'm like, ew. Like, because what I'm thinking is, I don't want you touching over the vegetables and shit. Like, you didn't even have the decency to put on a pair of sweatpants and a shirt. You roll out of your fucking bed in pajamas and a scarf. Like, come on now. But anyway, I'm on a rant and a tangent. But I don't know. It's just the way that you just need to come at people. And maybe, I don't know, maybe I'm wrong. Maybe a lot of 40-year-olds think that shit is cute. So maybe it's they're approaching what the norm is, you know, approaching women from what the norm is of how to pick up a woman. I don't know, I think I've just lost faith in love. I think that I've just lost faith in being in a relationship, because there's so many things today with social media and chow, and you'd be surprised of the men that approach you. They got like fucking newborns and shit, and 1-year-olds and 2-year-olds, and nigga, your baby still got fucking breast milk around its mouth. Why the fuck are you talking to me? Like, I don't want to deal with that bullshit. Like, my best friend Chi-Chi. She was dating my oldest daughter's father for many, many, many years. You know, after we broke up or he cheated. But her and I are like the best of friends. Like, she is just as much as my sister as my blood sisters. And I love her. I admire her. I respect her. I honor her. I cherish her. And that was something that we had to build upon through many years of building and trust and friendship. And I know that people see it as weird. Some people see it as weird. Like, how can you get along so well with the other baby mother? I'm like, I care more about her than the fucking baby daddy. Shit. Let something happen to her, my ass gonna be rolling all over the fucking floor and shit. Acting like these outlast days. but you don't get a lot of women that can be that mature and to know it's just not about you anymore. You know what I'm saying? Like, when they got together, it wasn't about him and I issues. We worked on our relationship and whatever the father's issues were, that had nothing to do with her. You know, so that had nothing to do with her and I relationship. And I just admire her so much and I love her to death. So I don't think that I could come across, if I met a guy and he had, you know, children and the mother of his child. Sometimes today's women they don't want to get along. They always want to kick up dirt. And I just don't want to be bothered. I'm too fucking old to be out there trying to smash. Okay? And I'm too thick and luscious for that shit because I ain't trying to be birthed this bitch in jail, okay? You know. Kudos to anybody else that like pussy, but I ain't into that bullshit, so I ain't trying to do shit to go to jail. So, wow, how long did it take me? 11 minutes. Same distance. I think because I'm talking on the phone. If I wasn't talking on the phone, walking and talking, I would probably got here sooner. Y'all see the color of my hair is coming out, right? See my blue? I love it. Oh, I just got dizzy all of a sudden. I need to take my vitamins when I get upstairs. God, I just got dizzy. I'm seriously dizzy. Oh, I don't know why I'm dizzy. Probably because I haven't eaten. Maybe that's why. Good morning. So, it's cute. But you know, my island is too damn small to be trying to talk to somebody because somebody knows somebody that knows somebody that knows somebody, okay? You can never keep shit on a DL or on the hush hush. Can I go? Yeah. Hello, how are you? Okay. Yeah, so that's it, y'all. Once again, rambling on again. It just passes the time by. My son's Respidone isn't ready yet. The Cogentin was ready, but the Respidol wasn't ready. So when I pick up Junior off the bus, I'll go get his medicine. Okay, I'm gonna go because my hands are cold as fuck. Yeah, my hands are cold. So, I'm about to put my hands in my pocket. So, I will talk to you later. Once again, thank you for spending the time with me. I'm almost home, so. I'll talk to y'all later. Have a great day. Bye.